start. In all these cases at hand, the High Court does not appear to have focused on the requirement to have due regard to the qualifications required by the agreement or other considerations necessary to secure the appointment of an independent and impartial arbitrator. It needs to reiteration that appointment of the arbitrator or arbitrators named in the arbitration agreement is not a must, but while making appointment, the twin requirements of subsection 8 of section 11 have to be kept in view, considered, and taken into account. If it is not done, the appointment becomes vulnerable. In the circumstances, we set aside the appointment made in each case, remit the matters to the High Court to make fresh appointments, keeping in view the parameters indicated above. In the aforesaid decision of the case of Northern Railway Administration held that the High Court in the said case did not appear to have focused on the requirement to have due regard to the qualification required by the agreement or other conditions necessary to secure the appointment of an independent and impartial arbitrator. In the aforesaid decision, this court also concluded that since the requirement of subsection 8 of section 11 was not at all dealt with by the High Court in its order, the appointment of an arbitrator without dealing with subsection 8 of section 11 of the Act became vulnerable, and accordingly, such appointment must be set aside. Similar is the position in this case. In this case also, before appointing an arbitrator under section 11(6) of the Act, the High Court had failed to take into consideration the effect of section 11(8) of the Act, as was done in Northern Railway Administration. In view of the discussion made herein above, and particularly in view of the principles laid down by this court in Northern Railway Administration, we set aside the impugned order and remand the case back to the High Court for fresh decision of the application under section 11(6) of the Act. And while considering the application afresh, the High Court is directed to take into consideration the aforesaid decision of this court. It is clear from the perusal of the judgment of the High Court and the records before us that the High Court had not terminated the mandate on the ground that the arbitrator could not pass the award within time. The appellant, along with six others, was prosecuted for commission of offences punishable under Section 148 IPC. The appellant and other accused attacked D. Two of the accused gave lathi blows on his back, and as he fell down, the appellant gave a knife blow on left side of his chest. That accused R also gave knife blows to him. PW2 further stated that when he and his uncle tried to save D, accused R gave a knife blow on his left hand thumb, and two other accused gave him five lathi blows. Stop.